Hello, friends. Nice to see you again. Today, we'll talk about the difficulties of forecasting the weather. 今天我们要谈论关于预报天气的难处。Now, let's look at a picture. 照片上这个像锅子一样的东西叫射天望远镜 ,radio telescope, 它是用来接收和记录来自天体和宇宙空间其他物体的无线电波。根据这些记录，气象专家可以预测天气。有这样先进的设备，预测天气还困难吗？ Now, let's listen to the text and then answer this question. Why do small errors make it impossible to predict the weather system with a high degree of accuracy? 为什么小小的错误会使我们无法完全准确的预测天气呢？
Beyond 2 or 3 days, the world's best weather forecasts are speculative, and beyond 6 or 7, they are worthless. The butterfly effect is the reason. For small pieces of weather, and to a global forecaster, small can mean thunderstorms and blizzards. Any prediction deteriorates rapidly. Errors and uncertainties multiply.Cascading upward through a chain of turbulent features, from dust devils and squalls up to continent-sized eddies that only satellites can see. The modern weather models work with a grid of points of the order of 60 miles apart, and even so, some starting data has to be guessed, since ground stations and satellites cannot see everywhere.But suppose the Earth could be covered, with sensors spaced 1 foot apart, rising at 1 foot intervals all the way to the top of the atmosphere. Suppose every sensor gives perfectly accurate readings of temperature, pressure, humidity, and any other quantity a meteorologist would want. Precisely at noon, an infinitely powerful computer takes all the data and calculates what will happen at each point at 12:01, then 12:02, then 12:03. The computer will still be able to predict whether Princeton, New Jersey, will have sun or rain on a day 1 month away. At noon,The spaces between the sensors will hide fluctuations that the computer will not know about, tiny deviations from the average. By 12:01, those fluctuations will already have created small errors 1 foot away. Soon the errors will have multiplied to the 10-foot scale, and so on, up to the size of the globe.
好，刚才的问题是 why do small errors...make it impossible to predict the weather system with a high degree of accuracy. 回答应该是 Because errors and uncertainties multiply. 因为错误和不可靠性会成倍的增加。好，这是有关天气预报的科普知识说明文，说明准确预报天气的难度。文章一共有4段。第一段指出无法完全准确的预报天气。最好的2-3天以上的天气预报有很强的猜测性 ,speculative。超过6-7天以上的预测就没有任何价值了 ,worthless。第二段说明原因，蝴蝶效应 butterfly effects 是造成难以完全准确预测天气的主要原因。butterfly effects 指微小的变化造成巨大的 结果，而气象预报员往往难以发现微小的变化，从而出现错误的预测。第三段和第四段讲的是进一步解释天气预报需要猜测，所以至今为止呢，没有绝对准确的天气预报。尽管现代气象模型以一个每个点大约60英里间隔的坐标图来显示，但地面工作站和卫星还是不可能看到地球上的每一个地方，所以开始时的有些气象资料也必须依靠推测。 Some starting data has to be guessed. 即使地球上布满传感器，并且能准确读出气象学家所需要的任何数据，同时计算机收集所有资料并算出每个点的情况，计算机也无法知道任何偏离平均值的变化。 Tiny deviations from the average. 因此即使在假设的条件下，也无法绝对准确的预报天气。而从语言上讲，这篇课文采用典型的科普文体的语言，准确的专业用词，句法结构也非常清楚，注重呢客观描写，不带任何感情色彩。好，了解了课文大意以后，我们来学习重要语言点。 So let's move on to language points. 蝴蝶效应在这里其实讲的是混沌理论， Chaos Theory。 Chaos Theory 是与天气或大气湍流之类的动态系统相关的一系列理论。这个理论否定了18世纪末19世纪初的法国数学家拉普拉斯的观点。他的观点是可以根据对宇宙现状的足够认识来预测其变化。然而根据混沌理论，像天气这样的系统变化无常，不可能对目前状况有足够的认识。即使知道目前状况的细节，还是不可能对天气进行长期准确的预测。 The butterfly effect 也经常用于股票市场。我们来看下一个语言点。 Beyond 2 or 3 days, the world's best weather forecasts are speculative.Speculative 意思是 based on guesses or on a little information, not on facts, 推测的。 The world's best weather forecasts are speculative. 世界上最好的天气预报都具有推测性。这句话的含义是没有绝对准确的天气预报。我们来看一下 speculative 的一个例句。 Many financial forecasts are highly speculative because no one really knows what might happen tomorrow to affect the money markets. 许多财经预测都具有很强的推测性，因为没人真的知道明天会发生什么而影响到金融市场。好，来看下一个语言点。 For small pieces of weather, any prediction deteriorates rapidly. Piece, a part of something which is separated from a larger or whole body.零碎的部分，块、片的意思。Small pieces of weather， 意思是 small parts of the weather， 一些小部分的天气。 这句话的主要讲，气象预报员知道目前状态的细节，但却不可能知道一些小部分的天气，像雷暴雨和暴风雪。而这些小部分天气呢，会像蝴蝶的翅膀一样，引起一系列湍流的症状，席卷整个大陆。因此，气象预报员的预测就会出错。Weather 是不可数名词，只能借助单位词 piece 来表示数量。类似的例句有 I have another piece of news for you. 我还要告诉你一个消息。Piece of news, 一个消息。They are about 20 pieces of information on the bulletin board. 在布告栏上有大约20条信息。20 pieces of information, 20条信息。Errors and uncertainties multiply. Multiply, 意思是 to increase by a large amount, 成倍增加。Errors and uncertainties multiply, 错误和不可靠性成倍增加。这是因为气象预报员难以知道一些会引起巨大变化的小部分的恶劣天气，所以往往出一些小错，而这些小错呢，又使错误和不可靠性成倍的增加。Multiply， 我们来看一例句 ：Friendship multiplies joys and divides griefs。友谊可以增添欢乐，可以分担忧愁。Insects seem to multiply in hot weather. 昆虫似乎在热天成倍的增加。好，再看下一个句子。The modern weather models work with a grid of points of the order of 60 miles apart.Of the order of, 意思是 near a particular amount, not exactly, 大约，也可以写成 in the order of something. Of the order of 60 miles apart, 每个点大约间隔60英里。这句话主要讲气象模型坐标图上的点间隔大约60英里。根据下文，即使这样，地面工作站和卫星还是不能看见地球上的每一个地方，因此天气预报还得靠猜测。 Of the order of something 或者 in the orderOf something， 我们来看一个例句。She was paid something in the order of $1,500 for the story。他写这个故事，大概赚了$1,500。好，再看下一个语言点。At noon。The spaces between the sensors will hide fluctuations that the computer will not know about. Tiny deviations from the average. Fluctuations, 意思是 frequent changes in the amount, value, or level of something.波动。Fluctuations that the computer will not know about. 计算机不可能知道的波动，也就是指计算机不可能知道偏离平均值的变化。这句话主要讲计算机无法知道微小的天气变化，因此也就难以准确预测未来天气。Fluctuation， 来看一个例句。 At this time of year, there are quite wide fluctuations in the price of vegetables. 一年中的这个时候，蔬菜价格的波动幅度相当大。Wide fluctuations， 相当大的波动幅度。 Okay, so much for the language points. Now let's move on to key structures. 先看这一句。 Suppose the Earth could be covered with sensors spaced 1 foot apart. 假如地球布满间隔1英里远的传感器，这是一个条件句，用的是虚拟语气 could be。 条件句除了用 if 引导以外，还可以像这个句子 suppose 来引导，另外还有supposing, providing, on condition that, 来引导条件从句。好，我们来看一下例句。Supposing the plane does not arrive on time, we'll have to postpone the meeting. 假如飞机不能准时到达的话，我们就不得不取消这次会议了。Providing that you finish your work, you can go home early. 如果你工作完成的话，可以早点回家。I can lend you the money on condition that you pay it back next month. 我可以借钱给你，但条件是你的下个月还给我。好，下面一句。 By 1201, those fluctuations will already have created small errors1 foot away. By 在这句里面意思是在12:01之前，引出时间状语从句，常常与将来完成时连用。 Will have created。好，我们来看两个类似结构的句型。 We shall have finished the work by 5 o'clock. 5点以前我们能完成工作。 He will have received the facts by tomorrow morning. 明天早上之前他能够收到这个传真。好，今天我们学习了有关 butterfly effect 的知识，在课文里面它是指细小的变化对气候的影响。 butterfly 总是给人留下轻盈优美 飘然的印象。所以英语里面管那些漂亮善于交际的女子叫 social butterfly， 交际花。把那些喜欢追求心意的人叫 have a butterfly mind， 见异思迁的人。 OK, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.